So welcome to tip number 7 on how to improve our memory. In this post, I will be focusing on the impact of stress, or chronic stress, I should say, on our memory function. Well, a number of different things actually trigger the stress response in our mind-body system. The first one being perception. When we perceive that something is threatening our psychological or physiological well-being, we immediately trigger the fight or flight response. Another reason why we get stress is when we get hungry. You see, our brain represents 2% of our body weight, but it actually represents 20% of our energy demands. And our brain doesn't like to go hungry. So if our brain at any moment in the day senses that there's not enough glucose in the system, it'll immediately trigger the stress response because the brain wants to be fed. Little known fact for you, in 2018, the word hungry plus angry, hangry, made it into the dictionary. Did you know that? The stress response is quite a dramatic biological state, which requires a lot of inner resources from us. When we trigger the fight or flight response, we primarily secrete two hormones, adrenaline and cortisol. And these two hormones tell the body what to do. So for instance, our heart begins to beat faster, our blood begins to flow quicker to our extremities, our muscles begin to come tense, we power down our digestive system and our immune system. So it's a very resource-hungry response. And as you can imagine, the memory function, acquisition, consolidation, and retrieval, also requires resources and energy to operate properly. But during the stress response, most of these resources are allocated to the fight or flight response. So that's why there's very little room for memory acquisition, consolidation, and retrieval. So if you want to improve your memory capability, you're going to have to find ways to manage your stress effectively. And there's so many different things that you can do, but the top three, and we've covered this at length before. Number one, sleep. You gotta get your 7 to 9 hours of sleep every day and try to be in bed by 10 p.m. Number two, exercise. Remember, you gotta get at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity activity a week, okay? And that includes power walking, running, swimming, cycling, and you can do wonderful exercises like yoga as well. And number three, meditation. If you can get to meditate at least 5 minutes a day, every day, that will do wonders for your stress management. There's so many other things that you can do to de-stress. For instance, you can listen to music, you can get a massage, you can draw, you can socialize, you can take a hot bath, or you can make a love. I don't know, so many different things. If you wanna get some more ideas, just text me or send me a message and we'll keep the conversation going. As always, I would love to read your comments, so please type them in the section below. And if you like this video, like it and share it. And of course, if you want to know more about this particular topic or any in connection to how to achieve your ideal performance state, subscribe to my channel. Always at the service of your well-being. Bye-bye.